Now, when I arrived here at Ping's HQ in Arizona, I was told there was a new category of product. That's not something I hear very often, so I was quite intrigued, and really what they call is the crossover. Now, this is a club which will sit between the iron and the hybrids to bridge that gap and really give another option for people who need a different type of performance. Now, if you remember the G15 or the G20 hybrid, you remember it had a quite an iron style look to it. It's got quite a sort of bulky head, and I really quite like that club. It wasn't maybe a looker, but it did perform very well. Now, they've moved this into a sort of an iron style. Now, this is not a driving iron, as I've been told to tell you. It's probably a little bit more than that, and I'd probably have to agree with them. When you put it down at address, it does have that sort of iron look to it. It's got a little bit of an offset. It's got quite a large sort of head, which is probably a little lot thicker towards the toe end. And now within that, there's a lot of weighting on the insides of the head, which is there to balance out the weight of the hosel. And that is there to increase the moment of inertia, or the resistance to twisting, to try and give you a straighter flight. Now, because it has a straighter face than a hybrid, it should provide something that's a little bit more consistent for those players who find hybrids a little bit harder. So let's see how this goes. But really, right from the first time I hit this, I thought it was really good. It's got that iron sound to it, but it's got a little bit of a ting sound to it as well. It's quite a high flight, but for me, it was going through the grass a lot better than a hybrid did. With the hybrids, particularly G1s, they've got quite a sort of relatively flat sole. It's quite a wide sole, whereas this one was getting into the turf a little bit more for me, and that was helping the performance. Now, the flight is quite high, and Ping are okay with that. When I had put this on Trackman against both the G hybrid and the 4-iron from the G irons, it was giving a very different level of performance. I was getting a much higher launch, but I was actually getting more distance because it was actually spinning a little bit less. And really, that is because, a little for me anyway, because the iron's going into the turf, obviously you're lowering the sole of the club and then you're hitting it more in the middle. Now, it depends on what type of player you are as to whether the crossover or the hybrid, or maybe even the iron, is going to be the best one for you. For me, I think it's going to be the crossover. Now, the great thing about this is it doesn't behave like a hybrid, it actually behaves like an iron. So if you want to knock it down or shape it a little bit, then it has that option. But if you just want something to go straight, then this really is the club for you. And I can see a lot of better players really going for this. Maybe where the G15 hybrid did have a bit of an image problem, this I don't think really does. I mean, it's got a very distinctive look indeed, but you know, it's not one that's particularly going to divide that much opinion. And really, if you're a better player and you're looking for a hybrid replacement because you want something to go a little bit straighter, then the crossover is definitely a club to check out. When Ping say they create a new category, I think I'm gonna have to go with them on this. I think this is a little bit of a hidden gem. They're quite excited about it, and I think you should be too, so go check it out. That's all for me today, so for more reviews on all Ping equipment, please check out the website at golfalot.com.